can just do this review as myself. And since this is a special review, I have an excuse to have some special theme music! In 1986, Shigeru Miyamoto created a non-assuming game for the Nintendo Entertainment System called The Legend of Zelda. Well, non-assuming other than the gold-colored cartridge. It was a groundbreaking game and pretty much spawned the action-adventure genre as a result. So far, 15 games have been released, with one more on the way which I'm really looking forward to, and it's so far started to be a pretty lucrative franchise for Nintendo. I myself have played quite a few of the games. Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask were the first ones, but I really didn't start liking the franchise until I played the Game Boy Advance remake of A Link to the Past, which I sadly haven't completely beaten. I played small bits of Zelda 1 and 2 later on, as well as Wind Waker, but I know that one Zelda game in particular will always be my favorite, no matter how many people disagree or say I'm an idiot for liking it over Ocarina of Time. Twilight Princess. But of course, somebody got that before I did. I couldn't learn to reply to these collabs faster. However, maybe that's for the best, because instead, I get to talk about one of the most underrated entries in the Zelda franchise, the Minish Cap. From what I've seen, this game got mostly positive reviews, but very few people have actually brought it up, which is a pity. As far as I know, when it came out, it made Game Informer's Handheld Game of the Month, and the AVGN brought it up.
The Minish Cap, also on the Game Boy Advance, is involved in the Four Swords saga as well. It tells of the origins of Vati and the Four Sword, and is mostly believed to take place at the beginning of the timeline. That's right, another fucking prequel. How far backward can we possibly go? Many other theories place the Minish Cap at the very end, and still others clump it together with the other Four Sword games somewhere in the middle of the timeline. Others speculate that the Four Swords are their own separate series. However, most believe the Minish Cap is likely the first game in the entire saga, as its geography seems to be most similar to that of Ocarina of Time than any other game.
But that's about all the reviews I've seen of it. So I guess you could say I owe it to this game I actually did have a lot of fun with. First, let's talk about the story. Despite the fact that this game is only one player, it's actually a prequel to the Four Swords series, and there's a lot of theories as to where it takes place in the Zelda timeline. But a better reviewer than I brought that up already. This Link and Zelda are childhood friends, and at first it's just an innocent story about them going to the Royal Festival. A sword fighting contest is held, but the winner is Vati, the villain who would later go on to be the villain of Four Swords. But even after he won, he decides that just for shits and giggles, he's gonna take over Hyrule.
Of course!
Fortunately, as with Wind Waker, Link is apparently connected to the ancient hero of legend mentioned in the beginning of the game. So it's his duty to save the princess and Hyrule from certain destruction. Now, as with pretty much every Zelda game save for the first, there's a gimmick to Minish Cap. See, unlike in previous Zelda games, the Master Swords was not forged by the three goddesses Din, Nehru, and Furore, but apparently by an ancient race known as the Minish, who are incredibly small. Fortunately for you, there's a magical talking hat named Ezlo who is willing to take you into the world of the Minish, which basically just means you shrink. That's right, people. Unlike some other exposition fairies, you suck, Navi! Ezlo actually does useful things.
Cool, huh?
And if you thought Hyrule was dangerous before, try facing it when you're the size of an ant. This actually works in the game's favor, however, because I don't think that a fight with a choo-choo could ever be made so epic. But if you think this game is just going to be fights with a bunch of regular enemies that appear larger, think again. Because there are several other excellent ideas that hold this game together. It not only features two of my favorite items in any Zelda game, the Gust Jar and the Rocks Cape, but also two of my favorite dungeons. And like most Zelda games, this one has great music, especially this track from the Temple of Droplets, which happens to be my favorite dungeon in the game. Pretty much takes care of what I can show you of the story without spoiling anything. So now, as a reviewer, you're probably asking me, but where are the flaws? Well, they are there, but thankfully there are few. About two that I can think of, and they have to do with two different mechanics in the game. One of them is the ability to make a projection of Link when you use the sword on certain spaces. It works well for the most part, except if the clones touch a wall, get hit, or you lose your magic, they disappear. And this room right here? Yeah, you're gonna hate it, because apparently the sword doesn't allow you to just create one clone. Oh no, you have to create two or three once you unlock that ability, regardless of whether you want to or not, which makes this puzzle harder to complete since, spoilers, you come back to this room quite a bit. And second, there's a mechanism this game uses called Kinstone Fusing, where you basically go around collecting stones to put together with NPCs who have the other halves. Sometimes this results in a special reward, and sometimes it actually changes the environment. It works well, for the most part, but you see these three statues here? They require special gold kinstone pieces to open, and sometimes I could not get the third one to appear. Either way, I say that despite its flaws, the Minish Cap is a highly underrated game, and one that I recommend you buy if you're a Zelda fan. Hello?
We need your help at the Muscular Arms apartment complex.
On my way, Agent Smith. Sorry, guys, but it looks like I'm going to have to end this review here. I hope you enjoy the rest of the Zelda Collapse entries, and with that, it's time to go to work.
Cartoon cliches, give me your power!
You keep your eyes on this corruption. Come on, yes, you should watch this trend.
I got here as fast as I could, Agent Smith. What's the problem?
A second-rate reviewer called Gentleman Gloves bought a tome of Eldritch lore off eBay called the Shyamalamacon.
The Shyamalamacon? What's that?
The Shyamalamacon. A powerful book of Eldritch lore. Wrapped in human failure. It wasn't meant for the eyes of mortal men. But I'm a reviewer. And my ego shall make me immortal!
Not so fast, Gentleman Gloves!
Born to be king!